chaplain service goes back almost 1,000 years. Hospitals were first started by the Catholic Church, in which it was not a separate entity, but as a function within the ministry of the church. Later, when hospitals were separated from the church, spiritual care was just an integral part in patient well-being, as well as physician care. Today, chaplain service within the hospital organizations remains an integral part of hospital care. In this presentation, we will cover and answer briefly 4 main questions that will show the life and expectations of becoming a chaplain. Also in this presentation, I will answer the question, how vital are hospital chaplains in the aid of patient recovery? Chaplain duties span a wide range and pertain to many different people. Chaplains have duties that not only pertain to patients, but also to their families as well as the medical staff. Chaplains have to assess what religious background the patients are and then assign someone within that belief system to better assist the patient. If no one fits the criteria, chaplains have to generalize their approach in order to aid the patient. Chaplains help patients by being a listening ear to patients who need to talk about their prognosis given by the doctor, and also chaplains help patients make decisions when given surgical options, for example, that might conflict with their religious belief. Chaplains also serve the family's patients during these times, offering prayer and guidance, particularly during the times when doctors have said further surgery and or procedures is futile to keep the patient living. Chaplains also assist the medical team with various needs that they may have. Doctors and nurses spend a lot of time with patients and their families and sometimes can become emotionally connected. And when the patient doesn't recover, chaplains are there for counseling for them as well. Chaplains also hold services within hospitals for anyone who desires to attend. One of the most debated topics among medical professionals are, do chaplains positively really have an effect on patient recovery? Well, many studies and research has been given to this topic throughout the centuries, and studies have shown that many times that patients who receive spiritual care come out better versus those who do not. When faced with certain recovery or surgical procedures, patients have to be psychologically ready to endure what could be an arduous task, not only physically, but also mentally. Chaplains aid patients with scripture reading, prayer, sacraments, for example, to give patients hope and fortitude that they otherwise might not have. Doctors are not trained for this side of patient care, and nurses receive little, if any, training. Chaplains that are certified to have received a bachelor's degree plus 3 years of additional theological seminary training. They also have to do at least 1,125 hours of clinical supervised training. With this training, they are able to aid a wide variety of patients with various circumstances. Chaplain benefits vary from organization to organization. Depending on the budget and size of the hospital, chaplains may be placed on a salary if their services will be needed frequently. If services are not needed on a regular basis, chaplains may be paid on a case-by-case basis. If the chaplain meets APA standards, chaplains will be able to request higher pay because of the qualifications they have met and the rigorous training they have completed to earn their certification. Most chaplains on average are on-call employees and can work as many as up to 168 hours a week. Now, while this is not normal, they could work like this depending on the amount of chaplains on staff in ratio to the amount of patients in need. Chaplains range their salary, according to Les Christie, on average across the country at about $48,000 a year. Also, when they're on salary, they also receive medical care and 401k benefits, just like other organizational employees. A lot of times when people hear the word chaplain, they automatically think of the term religion. While it is true that most chaplains come from various backgrounds and represent various religious beliefs, it is bad to assert that they are unable to help someone who is non-religious. Chaplains go through many hours of clinical psychological training and are usually very good at being a listening ear and encouraging someone when the recovery or outlook seems arduous or grim. Hospital chaplains are aware that proselytizing patients can not only result in their dismissal, but it could also bring upon a lawsuit on the hospital organization, depending on the patient and their family. On the other hand, sometimes if a patient who is non-religious finds themselves in an unexpected scenario facing a difficult health situation, usually they will be more open spiritually than normal. Chaplains are trained to gauge this interest, and if a person is willing and wants further discussions, a chaplain at that point can either have a different chaplain who would suit their religious ideology better than they, or continue if the patient is comfortable with them. Thank you for watching this presentation. I know it was brief, but I hope you learned something about the life and expectations of becoming a hospital chaplain. I have shown that they are an integral part to the organization and do aid not only the patient, but also their family as well as the medical staff. Regardless of religious belief or not, chaplains are trained to be a service to everyone in need of at least emotional support. Thank you.